Shoulder girdle have two parts, which is clavicle and scapula. Okay, next. Okay, first, this one is clavicle. So clavicle, which is also known as collarbone, is a slender bone with an S-shaped bone that extends between sternum and the scapula. And it is only the only long bone that lies horizontally, and it is located directly above the first rib. And it functions to attach the upper arm to the trunk. And it provides support to allow free movement of the arms. Okay, as we can see in the image given, these are scapula, which is, it has the S shape. There are few parts in the scapula, which is sternal and acromial ends and shaft. Okay, next. Next, this is clavicle. So, this is scapula. And the scapula, which is also known as shoulder blade, is a flat triangular bone that located dorsally on the rib cage and lies between the second and the 7 to 9 ribs inferiorly. And there are three borders of scapula, which is superior border, lateral border, and also medial border. So as you can see in the image given, the superior border located at the above, and the superior border is the shortest border, and it ends in a scapular notch. And next, we have medial border, also known as a vertebral border, which is the longest border of the three, and it runs parallel with the vertebral column. And next, we do have lateral border, which is at the lateral side of the body, and it is the thickest part, in the thickest border. So these three borders meet strategically and form that the triangle shape of the scapula. And okay, next. So this is another key image of a scapula, which is, we have the inferior angle located at the below of the scapula, and there are superior angle at the superior border. And we do have acromion process, which is located here. It connects the clavicle and also the scapula.